In this video, we're going to learn how to create a pivot chart. So a pivot table is by default a way to summarize a large data set. So in this example, we have this giant data set with time frame, media source, the product advertised, and then all the information that resulted from that advertisement. And we summarize that into this pivot table, which has by product, and by media source, how much was sold in 2015. But let's say you want to share this with someone else. Well, that audience may need something a little more visual to look at than having them sift through through more numbers, even if they are summarized. So to do that, we want to insert a pivot chart. And to do that, you want to make sure your cursor is just anywhere in the pivot table. When you do that, up here, you get pivot table tools of analyze and design tabs. And you see if I remove my cursor from the pivot table, they disappear. So we'll put it back in. And in the analyze tab, just click on pivot chart. And you see on the left where this wizard pops up, you have all the charts available to you. And from your columns, to your lines, pies, etc. And along the top, you have further chart options of that basic style. So like here in the column, you have your clustered column, stacked column, 3D clustered column, and so on. And then down here, what you see is a preview window of what your chart could look like. And when you run your cursor over it, it blows it up so you have an idea of what your actual real life chart will be. So for this example, I want to do a pie chart and just a basic pie chart. So I click OK. And so we have our pie chart. And let's move this over so it's not over top the pivot table. And so you see a couple of options here, plus sign, which shows you options for chart elements. So we have our chart title, above the chart, overlay, more options. And here I can add solid fill, gradient. You see how this is changing. And the whole time it's showing me a preview. We actually don't want to fill. You can do shadows, etc. Just a ton of different formatting options that you can do to them. And that will apply to any of these elements. So one thing I do want to add is I want to add the data labels. And I want to add them. We'll put them on the outside so they're a little easier to read. So now that we have that, one thing we want to do is we want to change the title of our chart because it's not email. All Excel did here is automatically grab this first column label, but we don't want that. So, and actually we can just get rid of it because this already says sum of quantity sold here. So let's just get rid of our chart title. And now that we've done that, we have our chart here. And some things you can do, or some things you should know is that this pivot chart will be live and will reflect any change done on the pivot table. Likewise, if you make any change to the pivot chart, because it's connected to the table, it will change there. So for example, here's all of our products and our product code here. So if our product color codes and the legend. So if we click on this and we decide, I don't want to look at blouses or boots. So we delete them. And they're gone from here, but notice that our chart here got smaller because they also disappeared from the pivot table. If we add them back on the pivot table, same thing, you see that they've been added back to the chart. So just know that this chart is going to reflect any changes you make to the pivot table, and it's going to do it live. So one other thing to note, oh, so we did the plus sign, and then on the format sign, this is important too because you can do a lot of neat things here. So we have our basic pie chart that we created. We can go in and we can change the style. And again, as you hover over each one, you see a preview, a live preview on your chart. So different styles to choose from. I'm happy with just the basic one, so we'll keep that. We can also change the color of our chart. So this is the palette one, just that default one that Excel chose, but you can change that to whatever else. We'll stick with this one. Something I do want to show you is if you want to add your own color to this palette, what you want to do, if you want to make sure your company colors, your color schemes are on here, is you want to go onto the page layout tab here at the top. Under themes, choose colors, and here you can customize your own color. So you have your text background, etc., and you just go in, choose more colors, and under the custom tab, you would just put in whatever RGB colors make up whatever company colors you already use for your work. And then you would just give it a name here at the bottom, and it would just save it for future use for any of these color schemes. So if you decide later that, you know what, I just don't want this chart anymore, the pie chart wasn't the right one, you can right click as I did here, and then you can just change chart type. And you can say, you know what, give me a, well, line chart wouldn't make sense for that, but give me a column chart or whatever, and you can make any changes that way. We'll just go back to a basic pie chart, but just wanted you to know how to do that. To print this, so all you would wanna do, or the easiest thing to do, is just maybe move it a little bit over and highlight the cells around it. So this is within your print area. So we go up here, under page layout still, we can choose our print area. And we've set this and bring this over a little bit. And then under your page setup, you can see how I have already blown this up a little bit. You can go on your print preview and see how that will look printed. You can make your changes here. You know, landscape or portrait. Landscape is definitely a better option for this. Do your custom scaling, continue to make it bigger. Is 150%, and so on. And then that way you can have something that you can print out for your meeting to share with your audience. So I hope you found this video helpful in creating pivot table charts. If you did like it, please make sure to subscribe to this channel and to like this video. And this way you won't miss any future videos. Thanks for watching. Bye-bye.